Hello.
Hi, Dad.
Hello, sweetheart.
She asked about you many times.
I'll be there soon, hon. I just bought her some flowers.
Okay, just try to call her whenever you can. Take care. Hello?
Hello, sweetheart.
Hi. Who is this? Dad?
No, it's your husband, James. How you doing, honey?
I'm okay. I'm here with my sister. When will you be back?
Soon, honey. I'm on my way. See you soon.
refused to eat until you came.
And here I am. Hello, sweetheart.
Hi. Are those for me?
No, they're for you.
Oh, thank you. I was waiting for you. I was pretty bored, you know.
Why?
I couldn't remember how to play my guitar. I couldn't remember the chords.
She couldn't remember how to play the guitar.
Okay, I'll trade you.
Thank you.
I can see the words, but I can't quite pull them out.
I know a song that we could play. Wanna try?
Okay.
Darling, you can count on me till the sun dries up the sea. Until then, I'll always be devoted to you. Darling, you can count on me till the sun dries up the sea. Until then, I'll always be devoted to you. I'll be yours through endless time. I'll adore your charm sublime. Guess by now you know that I'm devoted to you. I'll never hurt you, I'll never lie, I'll never be untrue. I'll never give you reason to cry. I'd be unhappy if you were blue. Through the years my love will grow, like a river it will flow. It can't die because I'm so devoted to you.
How did you know I love these flowers?
Maybe you don't remember who I am, but I remember you. Your name is Diane, and I'm your husband, James. You love flowers and nature. You were born in the summertime. You love seashells. You love music, and you have a beautiful smile. We were married on February 14th, and I still remember the promise I made to you on that day to love you forever and to take care of you for the rest of your life.
To the most beautiful woman in my life.
Thank you.
Where's my sister?
Wait, I have something for you. Dear Dad, thank you for showing me what love is and teaching me how to love.
You've always been there for me, not only as a father, but as a best friend.
You've always shown me how to take care of others, and especially now, your soulmate, my mom.
I've learned what it truly means to love your spouse.
When you love someone,
you do whatever you possibly can
to make them happy.
You are the biggest influence in my life.
And I'm eternally grateful. With all my love,
your daughter, Angela.
My brother had Lewy body disease, and at a very difficult time, over a period of years, my sisters and I knew something was wrong before it came out that he was having problems. So a man who was someone I looked up to and someone who was the captain of his own ship, slowly over years, went away.
My mother had dementia from the time she was about 70. It had started with a bad bus accident where she was severely injured and had broken bones and a destroyed pelvis. My brother and my sister and I all had been calling home, and we knew that there was something not quite right. And from there, it gradually got worse and worse.
My mother has Alzheimer's. She was diagnosed approximately 10 years ago, right around the time of my parents' 50th wedding anniversary. Although for a year or two prior to that, we began noticing that Mom was forgetting things that recently happened or asking to repeat something that we had just talked about.
My personal experience with Alzheimer's really stems totally from my wife Twyla Jean's mother, who has been suffering with the disease. And what has been heart-wrenching over the years is this slow, gradual loss of course, first her memory, and then some of the physical capabilities.
People with Alzheimer's, you know, they tend to remember stories but have a hard time remembering time frames and stuff like that. For instance, my uncle, while we were down in the basement, there was a pool cue that had been broken as long as my brother and I can remember, and he was down there and telling us a story about how a couple high school kids were there a couple weeks ago roughhousing and broke it. And my brother and I shot looks at each other like, that's been broken for a long time.
I have had lots of family members who have dealt with both dementia and Alzheimer's. I lost my grandma to Alzheimer's back in June. She began to show signs of dementia and Alzheimer's when I was 14. It was a really difficult time because I'd always had all of these ideas about how when I was going to get into high school and, you know, finally get into my teenage years, we could have discussions about politics and she could teach me how to sew and it would be this amazing experience. And it was really hard for me when the disease hit her at that moment in my life. And it really didn't start to get bad until I was about 18 or 19, and that's when the Alzheimer's really kicked in and she had trouble remembering any of us altogether.
An Alzheimer's patient drifts from this world to another. It's very hard when they are no longer there, and yet they are. They're surrounded by faces without names. They can't find the words to express themselves.
My parents had a very nice 50th wedding anniversary 10 years ago, and we knew that we were beginning a long process of a slide towards what my grandfather had gone through.
Caregiving often calls us to lean into love we didn't know was possible. To care for those who once cared for us is one of the highest honors.
My dad, his level of patience with her is something that set the tone for the rest of us, showing us how to age with beauty and grace. The last 4 years for my dad have been extremely difficult. It's 24/7, and it would go from the repetitive behavior to the anxiety-driven behavior to starting to not recognize things, not recognize people, to not being able to rely on your partner to pay a bill or to cook a meal or to write a grocery list or to, it goes on and on and on.
My great uncle Emmett, he knew that we were important to him in some capacity. He remembered our faces, but he didn't remember our names, and he didn't remember who we were in relation to him.
Well, I have such great respect for caregivers, and had to deal with people who were caregivers almost as much people who had the disease. In fact, that more so, the caregivers would come in depressed and anxious, and when I saw the caregivers give everything they had, it was very special.
Having this experience filming this movie, it really allowed me to put myself in my dad's shoes and kind of try to understand how it feels when the person who raised you your whole life looks you in the eyes and can't tell you anything about, you know, who you are. And that was hard, but I think this experience has allowed me to really think about that and kind of connect with my dad in a way that I never really thought was possible. So I will carry that with me for the rest of my life.
This production has taught me about how much love and devotion is really required in a relationship that where one member is dealing with Alzheimer's.
Really all you can do for people with Alzheimer's is be there for them, reassure them that they're loved, they're important and validated.
It's the only requirement, really, to be with somebody with Alzheimer's. All you can do is be there. All you can do is show that love that they know you for.
Because they don't understand anything else. It's a very personal connection.
You're still there to, you know, help them in any way possible.
Even though they are starting to lose their memory and lose all of the things that have happened in their lives, they still have the same love that they've always felt for you, and you just have to work a little bit harder to pull that out.
Love is an action. It's not about what you know. It's about what you do.
It really gets down to acceptance for the caregiver and staying with their loved one that makes so much difference. When you have that acceptance, then you can be tolerant and not intolerant.
You can be patient with them, and you can do the things that they love to do and support them in any way possible and just show them love. And that might be a better deterrent for the disease than any medication that you could prescribe that person.
My father went from thinking he could handle this to he can still handle this to he can handle this no matter what. He used to say to me, "I love your mother. It's for better, for worse. This is the worst."
The real test comes when the going is tough, not when it's easy, and Alzheimer's is one of the most difficult things to have to deal with in a relationship.
Well, when I was in the early years of social work, I went to nursing homes, and one of the things that I noticed is that the programs that they had that involved singing and dancing, people would become alive. And even though they didn't know the names of the people who came to visit, and their sons and daughters and their husbands and wives, they lit up and really loved the visiting. And if they lost their memory, we start singing a song, and they knew that song and sang that song with us.
It was very strange, and I would go to visit. I would stop on my way home from teaching. I would show her pictures from the family and name the people in the pictures. When I started doing that with her, she would remember some things, but not others. And then eventually she really didn't remember any of it and couldn't talk about any of it. But she always loved music. She was a singer. And so whenever music came in, because they had all kinds of people coming in to do music by piano or guitar, and she always sang along. She remembered words like crazy. She couldn't remember other things. She couldn't remember who people were, but she remembered those words.
I've noticed that with older people in general, including many Alzheimer's patients, there seems to be an ability to remember artistic endeavors that they enjoyed in the past, music in particular. I'm a musician, and when I perform for nursing homes or assisted living facilities, I find that often the Alzheimer's patients really enjoy singing songs from their past.
My mother and father-in-law were avid square dancers, and if we were in a situation where there was dancing involved, say at a wedding, my mother-in-law then would immediately transform from being confused to dancing like a queen. And it was amazing how those memories, even that muscle memory, would come back, and she would forget about any frustration and just have a wonderful time at the wedding. And those kinds of things were interesting when you would see that happen, where things that she still could do would come back.
My dad used to say that different friends of his, different relatives, different people in the medical community would give him advice or give him booklets or pamphlets on how to manage Alzheimer's. And my dad used to say, I, of all people, understand Alzheimer's, because he found a way to relate to my mother that was pure and simple love. And although there were many challenges, he was very successful in caring for my mother so well for so long.
Paul is someone that I am enjoying getting older with. And I have never felt that way before and never thought about it before. But we talk about that every once in a while together, and mm-hmm. how we've been through surgeries and falling down. Paul used to be a runner and took a bad spill, and that ended his running, but he used to run marathons. And we still love each other, and despite or because of the things that have happened, and life is good.
Yeah, the adversity brought us closer.
I think so.
You know, and the rocks in your head fit the holes in mine.
That's right. How true.
I love you, doll.
I love you too, Paul.
I think the gradual loss of memory doesn't affect the gradual loss of love.
Through all of the frustrating challenges, the one key ingredient that allows us to cope is the unconditional love that continues to bloom forever. We remember their love when they can no longer remember.
Where is she? Why is she late?
To love somebody the way I love you.
To the most beautiful woman in my life.
You don't know what it's like. Baby, you don't know what it's like.
love somebody, to love somebody the way I love you. To love somebody the way I love you.